soil after all these years, because we're not using any grass killers in 2010, so this is the fourth year. It's really the soil that changed color. And the nice part of doing organic farming is that even when there is some kind of disease, in a way the vineyard gets a little bit stronger, so it's harder for the vineyard to get sick in a way. So this year, for example, there was a kind of disease, and everybody that is, you know, normal agriculture, they were like, you know, what have you done? You know, mm-hmm. We're doing organic, and our vineyards were really strong.
Strong, they have more resistance.
And then we do use the, you know, the fava beans. We grow the fava beans in one row, yes, one row not. And mm-hmm. then we work with the soil, which yes. gives a lot of, it's good for nutrition, but it's also good for the humidity, because this is keep a little bit of humidity, the soil, which is what is really what we are facing for the last more than 10 years now. I would say it's starting with 2000, vintage. We had some very, very hot summer.
Yes.
So what we have to do now is to face this change of climate, working in a different way in the vineyard. So in the old days, I remember that my father put the rule that a Carmignano could not be called Carmignano if he didn't have more than 12.5 in alcohol.
Yes.
Now we have the opposite problem. You know, the wine can be very... So what we are doing now, instead of taking the leaves out for both sides, we're just taking the leaves out from the part where the sun comes in the morning,
mm-hmm.
and we're keeping the leaves from the one sun in the afternoon, so mm-hmm. it protects a little bit. The soil you will see after is a schist and clay, but you will see more with my brother.
Mm-hmm.
And the other change, but 6 years ago my sister was already here. She started taking care of the winemaking in 98 in Evetta. And everything was quite new. So now we always say, you know, after all these years, of course she has much more practice, and she has much more knowledgeable. And my brother Vittorio also helped us a little bit in the cellar too. So, you know, it's we have a strong team now.
How important is Vinsanto for the Capanciano?
Vinsanto, I would say, is for the prestigious point of view, is the most important wine. It's the wine that we definitely do more for passion than not for money. And because the wine is really, the Vinsanto is really what is fresh from the soil, from the terroir, from the area.
Mm-hmm.
For the...
What's your father? What's the president of this Vinsanto producers?
He was president of the Consorzio di Carmignano.
Yeah. Oh, Carmignano
sold.
Carmignano.
Yeah. Yeah. But he's always been very keen on the Vinsanto.
He was
always like, when people were like drinking Vinsanto, was like, say, you can't miss the, you cannot drink, you have to drink gold, you can't leave in your glass. And my sister really took over the Vinsanto very well.
I was with your father at some kind of a dam.
Mm-hmm.
They were making this dam.
Yeah, some kind of lake.
Yeah, some kind of lake.
It was the last lake was made the year my sister died, so which is 2006.
The lake still exists.
Yes, it's called Sant'Andrea. Which is good, you know, it's good for the irrigation, so we need that. Because my father started his career in the water.
Engineering. Yeah, I still remember.
Making lakes.
He was showing me around there.
In Africa, and so he made three lakes here.
Yeah, he was an expert on that.
And see, here you understand the second reason why our Vinsanto is so precious, and you see it in the barrels. Benedetta, who's the winemaker for Vinsanto, she says that every barrel is like a note, and the Vinsanto is like a symphony. Okay, this is because in this case, it's the barrel that makes the wine. Vinsanto is not really a wine, it's something completely different. In fact, the barrels are going to stay here for 6 months, we're under a roof, and this is because for 5 years, and in the 6 months in summer, they're going to be heated up to 40 degrees. That stimulates the fermentation. So this wine is fermentating every summer for 6 months, and then every winter is chilling for another 6. So it's doing this movement for 5 years. During these 5 years, the barrel is made with many different kind of wood. Usually you have the fruit trees from your own propriety, such as cherry trees, chestnut, pear trees, apple trees. It influencing and is making the wine. Now, as I said, every barrel has a different flavor, and the most unique flavor is made from those barrels over here. In fact, the yeast, since this is a very well fermented wine, what makes the wine is the yeast. And as you probably already know, the yeast, the more old they are, the better they make the product that they are making. In this case, in fact, some of the barrels, like this one, are over 100 years old. So the yeast inside are over 100 years old, and the taste that you have inside of your wine is over 100 years old. In fact, if you look well, you can see that some barrel like this one has here the copper figs. This is the thing that you do only in Vinsanto. Marco is the last generation that is actually able to do it. He learned it from his father. He's still able to fix the barrel with copper. This is to avoid that you have to change the piece of wood, because the piece of wood has the yeast inside it. So if you would change a piece of wood, you would lose a little bit the balance of the barrel.